The Radio Wammo Breakfast.
John Henderson's film review.
Thanks to Rialto.
My name is Bob Wilton. I'm a journalist. I've been investigating a story about a classified government program. So what you're saying is that you were a psychic spy.
A Jedi warrior.
I'd heard that the U.S. government was training psychic soldiers, and that Lynn Cassidy was the best of the best.
I've been reactivated. I'm on a mission.
I could come. Lynn's story was unbelievable, crazy, and completely true.
The Men Who Stare at Goats is the film review today with John Henderson. He's going to be giving us his thoughts. John, good morning to you.
Good morning, Wammo. What a strange and enjoyable movie this was.
What is it? What is it?
Well, I mean, it actually reminded me of some of the Coen brothers' early work. Very understated, wasn't too sure where I was going in this movie, but there were some very funny moments.
Okay, now it stars George Clooney. He's been busy of late.
He has. He's been in lots of things. We've spoken about him often. And he's, once again, very good in this role. It's also got Jeff Bridges, Ewan McGregor, and Kevin Spacey.
So that's a stellar cast right there.
It's a great cast, and they all shine. They really do. So the crux of this story is about these psychic soldiers. Psychic super soldiers. So Jeff Bridges stars as a sergeant in the U.S. Army who has an epiphany, some sort of experience in Vietnam where he ends up getting shot and has a vision.
Yeah.
So when he's recovered from his war wound, he manages to get some funding from the Pentagon to go and actually learn more about his inner self. And in doing so, he realizes that there is a whole plethora of psychic weapons at our disposal if we only know how to tap into them.
Oh, if only.
If only. So he sets about creating a sect called the New Earth Army, which is actually funded by Ronald Reagan because he's heavily into the occult, apparently.
Yeah.
It's been a bit like Hitler. And so there is actually covert funding going on for this. And as a result, there's a whole platoon of these guys that can do things like bend spoons, walk through walls, all this kind of thing. Now, it ends up getting disbanded, or has it?
Oh.
Now, Kevin Spacey plays a chap called Django who came into the project a little late in the piece in the 80s. He was the spoonbender, but that was about all he could do. So he is described as the serpent in the Garden of Eden. He ends up setting up Jeff Bridges to fail, which Jeff does, and he's fired, or court-martialed, I suppose, and dishonorably discharged, and the unit is disbanded, or has it.
Now, is this some kind of light relief to some of the heavier Iraq films that have been coming out recently?
Well, it's certainly not The Hurt Locker.
Mm.
And I think if we'd had the psychic army in The Hurt Locker, it could have been a very different movie indeed.
Mm.
They could have disarmed the bombs remotely.
Right, of course.
With their minds.
Yeah.
Or at least told everyone where the bombs were, so then everyone could have stayed away from them or something like that.
Yeah.
George Clooney plays a staff sergeant as well who has retired, or has he? He may actually be on a covert mission. Ewan McGregor plays a reporter who's actually looking for his next big break, and he...
Or is he?
Looks up, or is he?
Yeah.
Exactly. So many questions in this movie. A lot of good black humour. You see George Clooney kill a goat by staring at it. Hence the name of the movie,
okay.
The Men Who Stare at Goats.
Yeah.
The goats, they were using goats to train with during the 80s, so apparently they do this sort of thing where they shoot a goat and then they get the medics in to practice stitching a goat back together, because in the field they'd be stitching a person back together, and a goat's very similar to a human.
So there may have been some goats harmed in the making, or is it? Yeah. So there may have been some goats harmed in the making of this film.
Well, there may have been. I actually sat through the trailers at the end to see if there was a disclaimer. But there wasn't.
No.
Or was there?
Did you see this film?
Or did I?
Or did you? What?
Some of the classic humour, though, is just mint. For example, the goats have all been devoiced. so they can't bleat. The Bendy Bleated, I think they call it.
Right.
And at one stage, Ewan McGregor's talking to George Clooney, because Clooney's going, oh, you know, and I killed his goat just by staring at it. It was a terrible thing. And
well,
I
did
feel
he?
Bad about it.
Yeah.
And the thing is that, you know, it couldn't say anything. Couldn't even bleat. That's McGregor's going, it's like kind of like the silence of the goats. As in the silence of the lambs. It's just kind of humour the whole time. At one stage, Clooney's looking up at the sky as they're driving through the Iraqi desert, and he's cloud bursting. Well, and McGregor's going, what are you doing? And he's going, oh, well, it's that cloud. And he's going, what, the one way up there? And he's going, they're all far away. And he goes, I'm cloud bursting it. Keep me in shape. Now, what do you mean? He says, watch it. And sure enough, you see this cloud just disappear. It breaks into eight little bits and just disappears.
Hmm.
And Greg is about to go, that's amazing. And then they crash into this huge rock in the middle of the desert because they're so busy staring at the sky.
The only
now,
rock.
You would have thought, the only rock in the desert. And, you know, the airbags go up. McGregor's got a big gash on his head. He's going, you damned idiot. And you just sort of left thinking, surely one of the psychic soldiers, if he can cloudburst, would have seen the only rock in the Iraqi desert that just smashed their car into. It's brilliant stuff.
You love this film, don't you, John?
Yeah, I did. I did. I think I've heard patchy things about it. I don't know if you have.
I've heard sort of three and a half stars sort of material.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I think that's harsh. I'd roll it in at four.
Okay.
I would say it is an anti-war movie.
Mm-hmm.
Certainly light relief from some of the heavier Iraqi movies coming out. Someone likened it to Catch 22. Nah.
I take it it's no We Were Kings.
No, it's no We Were Kings, though I'm sure they were using some of the same old uniforms.
Hmm.
Yeah, and probably some of the crowd scenes as well. Now that was a great movie.
That was a good movie.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah, so this is all about psychic soldiers and the occult, and it's got four very, very good, very strong actors in it. And Kevin Spacey gets his comeuppance.
Or does he?
You'll have to go along and find out.
Thanks for telling us about this movie, John. Or did you?
The men who stared at goats. Or did they?
See ya.
Take care.
I went looking for a story, and my friend Lynn brought me an adventure.
It's okay, we're Americans.
We're here to help you.
What happened?
I think I just ran him over. Oh, crap.
Lieutenant Colonel Django used funds from the project's black budget to procure prostitutes.
That's a lie.
And to get drugs for himself and his men.
That... Well, the hooker thing is definitely a lie.
The Radio Wammo Breakfast. Catch that interview in video, on demand at kiwifm.co.nz.